heart failure is a condition in which the heart is unable to provide sufficient blood flow to sustain the body.
It's also one of the biggest health problems in the U.S., with over 7 million people currently having advanced heart failure, and being one of the most common health problems for our adult population.
Symptoms of heart failure are really quite varied. It could be something as simple as shortness of breath with activity, exhaustion, and then some of the signs could be lower extremity swelling, which is one of the hallmarks of congestive heart failure. So our program at Strong Memorial Hospital started in 2000. We've had our program to be approved as an LVAD center and recognized locally, regionally, and nationally as a very strong LVAD center. The mainstay of treatment is beta blockers or ACE inhibitors. Unfortunately, there is a large subset of patients that despite being on all of these medications and having the defibrillator implanted, where unfortunately their heart condition just continues over time to worsen.
HeartMate III is a so-called left ventricular assist device. HeartMate III has been the first pump that we implanted with this less invasive technique that we've developed here. We were the first one in the country to implant HeartMate III through a less invasive approach. So it's a mechanical pump that is fully magnetically levitated, and it's a pump that has a little rotor and it has magnets around that rotor. In that way, using a centrifugal force, pushes the blood out and pushes the blood to the rest of the body. That helps patients by adding additional 3, 4, or 5 liters of blood flow to the already existing blood flow that they have with their weakened heart. That procedure altogether takes roughly 4 to 5 hours. We implanted over 100 patients with this technique.
So this pump that I have in my right hand is called the HeartMate XVE, and this was the first implanted pump that was implanted in the year 2000 or so. And based on the implantation of this mechanical heart pump, it was shown that actually people survive much longer with this heart pump compared to, at that time, conventional medical therapy.
This newest pump has the same implant position, so this little tip goes inside of the apex or at the top of the heart, while the outflow graft comes out of this port here and gets connected to the aorta. It's just today we can do it through these two small incisions compared to a very big surgery that we used to have to do with the XVE pump.
In terms of the recovery time, looking at all the different pumps, it really is dependent on the surgical approach. The fact that these pumps are now implanted in a minimally or less invasive way, saving the sternum or the breastbone, allows the patients to get up much faster.
So patients are obviously always a little puzzled by what that means, that you have a little cord coming out of your belly, but at the end of the day, they feel much better going home, and they overall really, really do well with the pump. We really decreased our length of stay with this technique for a little less than a week.
They're able to get their quality of life back nearly to the point where it was before they were plagued with their underlying heart condition. I do think that minimally invasive LVAD implantation will be the future of the treatment of advanced heart disease, and also in the foreseeable future, having devices that are fully implantable. That is the key. Having a device that is fully implantable, where there is no longer an electrical wire that exits out of the body, because any foreign body that leaves the body and disrupts the integrity of the skin and of the body is a risk for infection. And so making a device that's fully implanted would truly be revolutionary and a game changer